So in Canada, there are only two toll roads. There's one in Ontario, one in Nova Scotia. What do we chalk that up to? Is it good engineering, the fact that there aren't many dense populations, or is it a formula that just doesn't work?
Once upon a time, you go back hundreds of years, there were lots of toll roads. They sort of fell out of fashion for whatever reason, I'm not sure, but once you don't have them, it's very hard to bring them in because politically people become very attached to whatever is the status quo. And the minute you charge even the smallest amount, people can think of a thousand reasons why this is the worst thing they've ever run across, even if it's, you know, a tiny amount. So I think it's mostly the absence of toll roads is mostly explained by politics.
Terry, I've seen some of the things that you've written, and you've called them a cash grab. So hot words aside, I want to ask you, what do you think are some of the cons? Because if they do help alleviate congestion, and they do help to bring in money for infrastructure projects, what are some of the cons?
Well, the first of all, it's not at all clear that they do relieve congestion. Look at London, for example, where they have a toll that's equivalent to $20 to come into the city. The city is as congested as it's ever been, and they're trying to work out new solutions. Wherever there are tolls, if you install tolls, people have to work to get around them, or they change their way of operating, or they simply keep paying the tolls and keep coming into the city, because people come into the city to do stuff.
So how do you augment revenue then for a city?
Well, that would not be the way that I would do it, and I'm not sure the city needs to augment revenue. So where Terry and I would agree is I don't think the city is short of revenues. It's trying to spend on way too many different types of things. But Terry's mixing together a lot of different issues here. He's absolutely right to say that the model that has been proposed so far in Toronto is about a revenue-raising thing. And there's a basic tension between the idea of using tolls to raise money versus using them to reduce congestion.
But traffic congestion is inherent in cities. Whether you have a toll or not a toll, you're going to get congestion.
Unless you price it. But the reason we have the level of congestion we have right now is the same as when you don't price anything. If you give it away for free, you're going to get congestion. We know that. That's why we price parking, for example. You'd never be able to find a parking spot. And the only difference between road tolls and parking fees is that the car is moving rather than standing still. But it's the same idea. You're taking up scarce road space.
No, but I'm not opposed to people paying for it. There's a difference between paying for the service you're getting and then imposing a price that reduces consumption of it.
Well, because there's
no business in the world runs
that way. Because people are imposing other costs on other people. Every time you're using the road, you're slowing somebody else down. You're imposing a cost on all the other drivers, and they're imposing costs on you. What we do in a market economy is we price in costs so that people have to take account of those costs in their decision making. And when they do, when people know what the costs of things are, and when they have to pay a price for them, then they use that resource more sparingly. That's true of roads, that's true of water, that's true of electricity, that's true of anything.
I disagree on that last bit. No, nobody prices something to reduce the supply of it or to reduce consumption of it. They put a price on something to make a profit.
Well, of course, yes, yeah, they do. But the reason why prices work in the economy...
Starbucks has lineups at certain times of the day, and they're not going to say, well, you know, we're going to charge more for the coffee if you come between noon and 2 o'clock. They don't do that.
They might if it became enough of a problem.
It's already a problem.
The airlines do charge you different prices to fly the same route at different times, different times of year.
Yeah, well, they have a lot of pricing.
Hotels will charge different prices depending on different times of year, depending on the level of traffic. So it doesn't. There's not enough of a payoff.
But it's a profit.
Of course it is.
But it's a different motive.
The point of it is the same, though, is rationing resources.
That's the effect, but it's not the purpose.
Well, of course.